sitting on her front porch in the early morning breeze. Sitting on her front porch, just an old friend and me. Drink a little coffee, read all the local news, talk a little gossip every now and then. Smell that ham cooking in the kitchen, a brand new sunrise in the sky. Sitting on a front porch, minding all your business. What a way to make the day go by.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And good Thursday morning to you. Welcome to the front porch. My name's Kenny Dean.
Good morning. I'm Terry Mitchell. It's great to start the weekend with you on Pi Day. Good morning to you, KD.
314. See, get it, Pi.
You got it, man. Glad we had that conversation.
Ain't but one pie, and that's Miss Hosea.
That's right. Pope. Thinking about it this morning.
Lord have mercy, Jesus. Good morning to you, Miss Pie, wherever you are. Let's see who we got. The one and only Mike Dinsmore.
Ooh, I tell you what, the world's glad and good and fortunate there's only one. Y'all do it.
We're great. Good, my friend.
Hey, I ran into a gentleman yesterday that thinks the world of Mike Dinsmore like so many of us do. Bill Hendricks. I talked to him for a while yesterday.
World, Bill Hendricks.
Tell you what, that's a good man.
You know, Bill, he's a class act. We talked about their son, Benjamin, who's going to be out here on the show hopefully in April. But just a good family. Came from a good family, and I've always thought the world of Bill Hendricks. He's a real guy.
Been through some tough times, physically, but got that chin up. And Benjamin, Lord have mercy, chin up.
Yeah, yes, that's why I'm looking forward to Benjamin coming out here just to let folks know who Benjamin Russell is. You know what a legacy that young man has, and I've never heard anything, but he is nothing but a class act young man.
Well, he's one of those, I don't talk about folks publicly, but
yeah, I do.
he is certainly one of those that when I make a comment, some of these young people give me hope for the future. He is one of those people.
Yeah,
yes,
yeah.
Sir.
You're exactly right. But I just had to tell you, I was over visiting Maggie and Nick and my grandchildren yesterday afternoon, and stopped I love to stop in the middle of the road when there's nobody, no traffic, and carry on a conversation. But I had to tell you that, and like I say,
I appreciate that, but I get emotional. I start talking about folks.
Well, and that's okay. You know what that means? You care about them. We truly care for them. Well, buddy, we have had a good 3 days. We got today, and if you can join us at 8:20, great. But if you're tied up, we certainly understand your schedule.
I'm gonna try to do that. And 8:20.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Well, we'll turn it over to you right now, my friend.
Well, we're still dealing with Lent. We're still dealing with some conversions, or at least things that I see conversion in. And today I want to take us to the 15th chapter of Luke. Now, if anybody wants to read a story of changeovers, the 15th chapter of Luke has been coined by some scholars as the gospel in miniature, because you've got the parable of the lost coin, the prodigal son, and the lost one in the wilderness. So you got all three of those in the 15th chapter of Luke. But today I want to read about the prodigal son, beginning with the 11th verse of the 13th chapter of Luke. Then Jesus said to the man who had two sons, the younger of them said to his father, "Father, give me the share of property that will belong to me." So he divided the property between them. A few days later, the young son gathered all he had and traveled to a distant country, and there he squandered his property in dissolute living. When he had spent everything, a severe famine took place through the country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to the citizens of that country, who sent him to the fields to feed the pigs. He would gladly have filled himself with pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself, he said, "How many of my father's hired hands have bread enough to spare, and here I am dying of hunger? I will get up and go to my father, and I will say to them, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me like one of your hired hands.'" So he set off and went to his father. But while he was still far off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion. He ran and put his arms around him and kissed him. Then the son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son." But the father said to his slaves, "Quickly, bring out a robe, the best one. Put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. And get the fatted calf and kill it. And let's eat and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found." And they began to celebrate. What an amazing story. The story of the prodigal son is full of lots of the world's stuff. We don't know what this young man's motives were for leaving home. We don't know if he got tired of living as the youngest son in a patriarchal society. We don't know if he got spoiled by the abundance of blessings and land of plenty. We don't know if he was just selfish for more and envious of things other people had, particularly his older brother. But he left, you know, to go somewhere and try to make it better. And we're left just to ponder about why he did it. But one thing we know that he said to the father, "Give me now. I want it now. I'm tired of living here." And when he talked to his father and said, "Give it to me now," he took his share and left home and abandoned the care of those at home who had loved him, supported him, and encouraged him all his life. When he got out in the real world, he was slapped right in the face with the shock of reality. He was away from home, among strange people, in a strange land, and before he knew it, he'd spent everything he had in what the Bible calls dissolute living. Now, I looked that up in the Greek, and that actually means unbridled morality. That means anything goes. And he found himself living that way, having nothing, starving, and beginning to eat for those people who were outsiders in his growing up. He had absolutely nothing, hired out. And if you can imagine the degradation of a young Jewish man eating among the pigs, then you start to get the picture. Then the scripture says he came home, came to his senses and went home. And when he went home, he found open arms, acceptance, and restoration. I'm going to say that again. When he went home, he found open arms, acceptance, and restoration. The lesson for us today is, when you're looking for love, you can't find it looking in all the wrong places. Just doesn't work. This is Lent, and we're called during this period of Lent to return home to God, home to the Father who loves us, home where we will be met with open arms, acceptance, and restoration. May we pray. Oh, gracious God, free us from ourselves. Help us turn our path and go home where we can meet those who love us and care for us, particularly you. Amen.
Amen. What a great story, and the story was told great, too. Wow.
Yes, sir.
I knew that story. I've read that story, but I've never heard it told like that until I just heard it from you, Mike Dinsmore.
I never have told it that way.
Wow. Wow.
I think that's where we are. I can remember growing up, you know, our parents told every one of us. I know all three of you heard it, and everybody we mentioned this morning heard it from their parents or whomever. We always think the grass is greener. Well, the grass ain't always greener.
I agree with you 100%. But you know what? I think it's good. You and I and Terry have all done a little traveling, and I think it's good to see those areas, and cause it makes me appreciate where I live. I love this town, like Terry loves his Coosa, and you love this this town. But I think going other places, it makes you appreciate it more. Maybe that's the word I'm looking for.
Well, Patsy and I have lived in a lot of different places, but we came back here to hang our hat. And the thing is, I love everywhere I've ever been.
Right.
And I told people just this week, I told somebody that, you know, I envy some people that live in the same place all their life and they can call everybody's kids and grandkids by name and all that because they've shared 60, 70, 80 years together.
Right.
I said, but the fortune Patsy and I have is we got seventeen different places we can go back to, and they're friends and people we love there.
Boy, that's a long line of relationships, my friend.
Well, and which one's best? I don't even get into it.
No.
We make decisions. There are consequences to the decisions we make in our lives, and we need to learn how to live with them in a positive way.
And if the truth be known, you truly moved back here so you could be living close to me. That's the honest truth.
You and many others.
Hey, buddy, enjoy your day. We look forward to, if we hear from you at 8:20, we look forward to that, my friend.
And love the whole community.
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Love you.
Love you, buddy. Oh, Mike Densmore, crazy about that guy. 46 degrees starting out this morning. Not bad. Today, it got up to about 74.
Well,
it got warm yesterday.
It's going to get warmer today.
80 and partly cloudy tonight. Going in tonight. No rain today. Slight chance of rain maybe during the night. 64 on low. Now, tomorrow, that's when we're talking about some rain. I'm talking about it's going to be 100%. 76 and 57. Rain chances have lessened all week on Saturday, 73 and 50. Even have come down percent on Sunday, 69 and 42. So tomorrow looks like it's going to be the rainy day. And then we're going to start off Monday, 60 and 31, 60 and 38 on Tuesday with no rain. There's your five-day forecast brought to you by the folks at Ellic City Marine, the Yerke family, just good people to deal with. I want you to go by and meet them today. Maybe you're not even looking for a boat, but they'll take time just to
jaw with you.
Go by and jaw with Ellic City Marine today. And if you want to find somewhere to jaw with some more folks, because you're going to run into somebody in there that's either getting or giving the Salvation Army. You can do the same thing. 6800 US 280.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Gorey at Gorey's Furniture. Come join us for the Madness of March. Come join us here at Gorey's Furniture. Make a purchase. Shoot from the line. 5, 10 to 15. That's percent discount off your total ticket. So come join us. Let's have fun. Everyone's a winner. Everyone will save. Come join us for the Madness of March. And that's only at Gorey's Furniture.
At Russell Medical, we're proud of our exceptional nurses, like Nurse Brandy Worthy. Brandy represents the selfless, compassionate clinical leader patients expect and coworkers admire. Brandy was recently honored with the Nightingale Award for Nursing Excellence for her high standards, sound judgment, and caring manner. Her passion for her profession inspires us all.
Being a nurse is not just what you do, it's who you are. I'm proud to be a part of the nursing team at Russell Medical. We are the link between all hospital services, providing you with exceptional, personalized care.
In today's challenging world, our children need every advantage found in their education and spiritual formation. If you're looking for a school for your child or your grandchild where they will receive a great education, be in a small class, a safe place, a school where they're prayed for and with, a school where the Bible is integrated into the lessons, a school where they're encouraged and challenged not only in scholastics but also the Christian life, Veritas Lake Martin Christian School may be the place for you. Registration for the next school year has already begun with limited spaces. Call us at 256-537-5004.
Let's get serious. Let's get Arctic Air serious. You want your car and truck to live longer, don't you? Well, it's about maintenance. same thing with Arctic Air. You see the number at the bottom of the screen? Call them right now. Let me tell you something. You want to be comfortable? We all want to be comfortable.
Serving East Central Alabama since 2005, we are Coosa Valley Respiratory and Home Medical of Sylacauga. Coosa Valley Respiratory has medical equipment and supplies, including oxygen-to-home ventilation services. We carry a full line of bracing, power chairs, scooters, and more. And when you trust Coosa Valley Respiratory, you are dealing with local people that care about your well-being. Providing quality home care for our community, Coosa Valley Respiratory and Home Medical, 201 West Fort Williams, Sylacauga. Give us a call at 256-245-1411.
The Alex City Parks and Rec Department serves the residents of Alexander City with quality facilities and programs designed to positively affect the lives of the citizens. From youth sports programs to adult activities and our senior center, the Alex City Parks and Rec offers services for all ages. The Cooper Rec Center, Lake Winds Golf Course, and the Senior Activity Center are just some of the great features the Alex City Parks and Rec Department provides for the people of Alex City. For more information on any of our programs, call 256-329-6736.
A1 Lock and Key Service. Owner Bernie Atkinson asked you to keep his number, 256-329-2539, on you at all times. Bernie has a complete locksmith service for auto, business, and residence. He is licensed, bonded, and insured with over 39 years' experience. Services include sales, installation, and a 24-hour emergency service. That's what service is all about. 256-329-2539.
Y'all coming back in here and join us. I know you can't see me, but you can hear me. Let's go to the lines. Miss Barbara, good morning to you.
Good morning to you, Kenny and Judge.
Good morning, Judge. How are you?
Sure wish you was out here.
Well, I have a story about Bill Hendricks.
Yes, ma'am.
And it's been recent that this story has happened, but I've known Bill for years. He has been so generous with the things he has done.
Yes, ma'am.
Most people may not know he's in the fitness industry, and when he sells fitness machines places, his crew and sometimes him travel and they, you know, either put the machines in or repair the machines, whatever needs to be done.
Right.
So this was told to me by one of his employees. He said, "Miss Barbara, it's not uncommon for us to be eating out, and there might be a table of 10, a family or a table of 10, and Bill go tell the waitress, I'm getting their bill."
Wow.
And he was talking about that, but the underlying thing, because I know Bill Hendricks, Bill is one, but those 10 people are 10, so that means that 10 more people go out and pay it forward.
Right.
And I was just overwhelmed with that, you know?
And that doesn't surprise, I don't think it surprises either one of us, Terry or myself, about Bill Hendricks. He's just a giver and not a taker.
Right, and he passes it forward, but by his passing it forward, whether people are able or not, they will go out and pass and give it forward. And I thought that is such a blessing, you know?
Yes. And Miss Barbara, you know, when Bill Hendricks or anybody does that, you don't know what you just did to their day. Maybe they're having one of the worst days of their lives, and he just changed their attitude.
That happens exactly. It happens so often. Even a smile from somebody would just change your attitude, you know?
I see it every day. I'm kind of on a mission every day. because, you know, being out and seeing folks and seeing their heads down, or, you know, a good morning, how you doing with the head down. Boy, you can pick that head up and you can get a smile out of them sometimes.
Exactly right. I just wanted to share that and these messages that you and Terry share and the love that you all have for the people, for us, our viewers. It's got to pass it forward. So I just wanted to share that. When I think of Bill, I just had my face just glows.
Well, you know,
plus he's married to Dee Dee, and that helps too. And no wonder Benjamin Hendrix is such a fine young man.
Well, you're exactly right. That's I've never heard anything but great things about Benjamin Hendrix. And you got to remember, let's be honest, Benjamin Hendrix is the only grandson of Ben and Lou Ann Russell, so he could just be a rotten kid, you know, have everything. But you know what? It kind of tied in with what Mike Densmore's talking about. You know, he wants to do it his way. I don't want it to be handed to me.
Right. Exactly right. And thank you so much for letting me share it, and thank y'all for what you do.
Thank you
for sharing that, because you know what? I believe with what Miss Barbara Sokol just shared with the front porch, whether it's on TV or radio, I think you just talked somebody into paying it forward today.
I hope so. And I will certainly look for opportunities to pay it forward.
I know you do, girl. We sure do love you.
Love you.
We mean that.
I love both. Thank you so much.
See you, girl.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Boy, I tell you bye-bye. What, KD, after Mike Densmore's comments, after Barbara's comments, all we can do is sing a hymn and go home.
Well, you know, let me tell you what, Barbara Sokol is somebody that we thought the world
you
of
and
for
I
years.
Think the world.
Because we've seen how Miss Barbara has been involved in this community. Is she from this community? Yeah, I'm going to say yeah. She's from Birmingham, but she and her family have made this their home. She's still involved. I love when she comes out here because she always brings something. She's not like me. I don't bring anything to the table. She brings something to the table, and I just love it. I love it when Miss Barbara comes in here and it's like 30 degrees outside. Miss Barbara is cold natured, and she's gonna be wrapped up. She got gloves on and everything.
She's been out here before. She knows it's cold out here.
Yeah, she knows that. Hey, I met a gentleman yesterday that I've texted with, I've never talked to. He watches the show and I think the world of him. But Mr. Jack Wright, I met him yesterday for the very first time, and I was not disappointed. And I'm still trying to get him on the show. He's been very much involved in the city council up in Hoover in that area.
He's on my list to call. Yeah. I don't know him. I'd love to meet him.
And remember, he worked for Reagan. Remember what I
told you? You sure did tell me he was in the White House.
Yeah, I forget what his, but he was.
Like a security clearance.
Yeah, but he is just a class act. So, Jack, whether you listen or not.
You need to arrange a meeting for me with him. I'd love to sit down and have a cup of coffee.
I think the world of Jack. I would not do that.
We could share political stories together.
I had lunch with Casey Lowe yesterday. Casey Lowe is a retired military, and he's living here. Not from here again, but he's involved. He does Meals on Wheels. He volunteers at the hospital. So it's in fact, if you have some time, I want you to get in touch with Melissa Edwards at the hospital to be a volunteer. Let me tell you what, it's very, you go get a lot out of it.
That's what I was fixing to say. You and I have been friends for 50 years or longer. I've never seen you get so excited about something like you do volunteering at the hospital.
I do.
I mean, yesterday morning you told me you were leaving. I said, you want to go to, nope, I got to go get ready to go to the hospital.
And I truly love it because I meet so many folks and I go in with a smile, I leave with a smile because you folks,
they do more for you than you do for them.
You're exactly right. It's just a good place. So let me give Melissa's telephone number, 256-329-7177. That way she can go, to take you through with what you'd have to do, where you'd be. I'd do it one day a week, one afternoon a week, Four hours a day.
Well, you spend more than 4 hours out there. I know you. You show up at Doc's, and if you want to go out and have lunch and just visit with some folks, go to Doc's. You'll find somebody to sit down and talk to.
Let me tell you what. I had a good meal out there yesterday. Pot roast over rice, Brussels sprouts, pinto beans, and cornbread.
I'm surprised you didn't take a nap after that.
Well,
and not work.
It does.
We're talking about Doc's Cafe at Russell Medical Center,
cafeteria,
by the way.
Cafeteria downstairs. It does cut into my nap time, but you know what? I'll make up for it. Hey, we're going to take a commercial break. We'll be right back. Where suns never end, and really where sun sets or sun rises. I know we're kind of throwing that in, but it's the truth. Lake Martin, Tallapoosa County Tourism sees what's happening to this area. They're right in the mix of it, and they're promoting tourism. It's something that we're probably promoting these days more than ever because it's there. Thank you, Lake Martin, Tallapoosa County Tourism.
Floyd's Feed and Seed covers both sides of the road in downtown Dayville. Incredible selection of plants, stones, insecticides, and gift selection in the additional part. Original store has tack and boots for men, women, and children, gloves, hats, belts, and Carhartt clothing. Come on in and visit. Open Monday through Saturday for your convenience with a whole lot of service. Floyd's Feed and Seed, downtown Dayville, Alabama.
We are Debt Relief Agency. We help people file Chapter 7 and Chapter 13 under the bankruptcy code.
This is Marcia Mason, your local Lake Martin Bankruptcy and Social Security Disability Attorney. Mason Law Firm is located at 217 Madison Street in Alexander City. Call 256-329-1313 to schedule your appointment today. All initial consultations are free and strictly confidential.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Trust Dixie Overhead Door to restore your garage door with a comprehensive tune-up. For a limited time, it's free for Dixie Cares Plan members and only $49.99 for others. Avoid a real-life nightmare and take care of the most important door in your home. Regular maintenance can reduce noises and potential breakdowns, extend the life of your opener, door, tracks, and springs, and quickly spruce up the space, especially important if it's turned into your new man cave.
Central Alabama. This is our home. It's where we work, where we play, where we raise our families and grow old. And in the unfortunate event we become sick with cancer, thanks to UAB Medicine Russell Medical Cancer Center, this is where we heal also. We have invested in new technologies and expertise so that now we're able to treat all sorts of cancers and you never have to leave Tallapoosa County. UAB Medicine Russell Medical Cancer Center. Compassionate, convenient, collaborative cancer care right here at home.
Farmers and Merchants Bank of Dadeville is building a foundation of strength and trust in the entire Lake Martin community. With our modern branch in Dadeville and caring, attentive staff, we've established Farmers and Merchants Bank as a reliable friend to your banking needs. Whether it's just a savings or checking account or any commercial, auto, or real estate loan, Farmers has local decision-making to build a relationship with you and your needs. Farmers and Merchants Community Bank. Strength. Service. Community. You don't have to ask who, what, or why. Who's Diner is the go-to place for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Conveniently located at the corner of Highway 22 and 280 in Alex City, Who's Diner offers the best meals and the best deals in town. Try our fresh made-from-scratch pancakes, chicken salad, Philly cheesesteak, or the Who Burger. It doesn't get any better than Who? Who's Diner, of course, on the corner of Highway 22 and 280. Who's hungry?
Henderson Towing, Alexander City, 24-hour towing, jump starts, door unlocks, local and long-distance towing, heavy-duty towing, So let's get old Big Hoss to the rescue today. Here's that number. Now keep it handy. Henderson Towing, 256-392-4554. 256-392-4554. Henderson Towing, 24-hour towing, 256-392-4554.
It's Thursday if you're getting up and trying to figure out what day it is. You know, my wife doesn't hardly ever keep up with days anymore. Since she retired, she doesn't have to. But today's Thursday for you folks looking for Mary Perry with us out here. Explain who you're with today.
Alex City Arts.
Okay. We'll make sure we get that straightened out before we get started.
Yes. I do have several hats.
I know you do. I always have to make sure before we get started that I'm a threat to let them know you got the wrong hat on sometime when you come out here.
Right. I have the hat, Alex City Arts hat on today. I should have worn my name badge. But
I know you.
I originally scheduled this to talk about the concert coming up a week from today.
Right.
But we had a problem. Mm-hmm. And we seldom have this kind of thing happen. Yeah. But one of our artists put the performance on the wrong date and scheduled something else on the date he was to be in Ellic City. He's going to be in Arkansas.
So how did that happen, man? How did y'all find out?
We found out when we got close to the planning and asking them, well, what do they want to eat and that kind of thing, he let his agent know that he had it booked on the 7th. So anyway, we scurried around and worked with the agent and worked with the artist and worked with the venue and everything, and we ended up rescheduling The Heart Behind the Music featuring Marty Rabin, Lenny LeBlanc, and Cindy Morgan for May the 7th.
Okay. There he is right there.
Wow. Yeah.
Picking and agreeing. And we were just talking about, he's lost a lot of weight too. Is this Lenny?
Lenny,
right?
Cool. And Cindy.
Well, she's pretty.
Yeah. She's pretty and she sings beautifully. Mm-hmm. But the three of them have been paired by Echo Media as The Heart Behind the Music. It's a series they started years ago where they pair up three different singer-songwriters, and they come and talk about their music and how they wrote their music and the stories behind their music, and they perform their music.
So. Do any of them write together that you know of?
Not that I know of.
Okay.
No, they all write, but they don't. As far as I know, they don't write together.
I'm familiar with Marty with the Shenandoah. Used to be with them. Has joined back up with them. They still toured sometimes. He does a lot of solo, like this is a solo. Mm-hmm. But so, tell me about the other two.
Well, both Cindy Morgan and Lenny LeBlanc are best known in Christian music circles.
Okay.
Cindy has won 14 Dove Awards, nominations, 14 Dove nominations, and some awards. Mm-hmm. And Lenny has also. Those of us who were in Christian music back in the 90s know Lenny very well for some of the standards, what have become standards of contemporary Christian music that he wrote then.
Let me ask you a question about contemporary Christian music. Mm-hmm. When did that start? Has it been started 100 years ago and I just didn't know anything about it?
Probably started in the 70s, but we it came into more popular appeal in the 80s and 90s.
I'm sorry.
A lot of the praise choruses that we used to sing in church started in the 80s and 90s.
I'm still a Flint Hill Methodist Church Cokesbury hymnal type guy.
I hadn't heard that word in a while.
Yeah, you've kind of claimed a lot of those Cokesbury hymnals by putting your name in them. They still
he set you up for that one, didn't he?
I don't like to knock any kind of music because I grew up with classic country music. I still love it. But so I think it's kind of what you listen to.
You grew up with Southern gospel music.
I did.
Too.
Yeah. See Go and Naomi. I mean, you know, Wally Fowler. I mean, I grew up with all that. But so we didn't consider that Christian. I mean, even though it was Christian music, mm-hmm. we didn't call it contemporary Christian, did we?
Probably not at the time.
Okay. So it was. You straightened me out on a time frame there.
Well, Lenny wrote some that have become classics, mm-hmm. like the song Above All. Mm-hmm. He's very well known for that song and for the song There Is None Like You. Mm-hmm. So,
how do people sit down and what determines a contemporary Christian song versus it's a song? I mean, because it's where it's going to be heard? On the radio?
Probably, yeah.
Well, and the composition. I mean, like what separates country from bluegrass? Is
yeah,
the
okay,
composition.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, I think the songs that were written back in the 80s were praise choruses, mm-hmm. we call them. Mm-hmm. And now they're full-blown production songs.
That's right.
Because before that, we didn't really have bands in the church.
Right.
That's right.
We had a piano.
As we saw
an
piano and an organ.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We saw traditional worship services changing in the 70s and the 80s, from being just the 11 o'clock service to morning services, and things begin to change, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. and ideas begin to change, and don't forget about we had Woodstock just before that everything was beginning to change.
What was it?
So there's a lot of changing going on, mm-hmm. in a lot of areas.
The 60s brought on.
Make a good song title.
That's
there's
right.
a lot of changes going on.
There's talking about the 60s, all that we went through in the 60s kind of changed everything in the 70s. You said mm-hmm. This started happening in the 70s.
Well, you had Vietnam War, and the way we were thinking was beginning to change, too. Like,
we're still doing it today.
Yeah, that's
it's
right.
It's just a different era.
It's just
different,
a different
time, different folks.
A different topic.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's always, we've always had change.
That's part of life.
Did your mom get you involved in music?
Oh, of course.
Okay. Yeah. But I don't remember your dad really being that much in.
He wasn't. He was quiet.
Yeah, he was. He was. But your mom, and I know we always bring this up about her mom and so many people that are still living, they know and remember your mom.
Yes, they do.
Sweetest soul I guess I've ever run. I kind of compare her to my mom Aldine, one of the sweetest women I think I've ever known in my life. And you remember, you know, your mom worked with a lot of young folks.
She did.
Over her, and they still remember Miss Wood today. Mm-hmm. They'll never forget her.
Yes, there are things about teachers. The students always remember
their
teachers.
You're right.
And when I first moved back to Ellicott City, Mother was volunteering at the hospital. And I would go with her, and she would run into former students that mm-hmm. remembered her, and she remembered them. And
we were just talking about volunteering at the hospital before you got here. Anaya Bruce, I got your message. She says she loves to volunteer at the hospital, and you're talking about when she used to work at the bank.
I met in the 70s, mid-70s, when I came to Ellicott City. One of the first people I met.
Worked at the school system. So, yeah, when you get out and start volunteering like that, I think that's one reason I love doing it, because I see so many people I've not seen in a while, mm-hmm. and I just love, you know, catching up with them.
Plus, it's a good safety factor for you, because I've been with you. You'll stop right in the middle of the street. You'll block traffic just to talk to people. If you're at the hospital, you've got your vehicle parked, and you're not a hazard.
You know what I'd say to so? I use this same old line to so many folks because, you know, somebody will come in on a walker, Some of them are a little faster than others, and I love to use this line of, don't you get a speeding ticket and that thing. And, you know, maybe they're not feeling good, but you know what? It always gets a little chuckle out of or smile. I'm thinking, I know I say these things so many times over and over, but, you know, you talk about seconds you can say something to somebody that's going to maybe make their day, and, you know, try it. You just try it today. Mm-hmm. Take a few seconds out of your life and try it today.
And both of you will benefit. Hey, Mary, we'll say it several times, but May the 7th will be the change of the date. Location will be
the same, Benjamin Russell High School. At 7 o'clock.
What you going to do when it's gone?
When the season's over?
No. When Benjamin Russell High School auditorium's gone.
Oh, I don't know. We don't really know, and I'm sure they don't know exactly yet. Mm-hmm. But I understand that the new high school will have a nice state-of-the-art auditorium.
Oh, yeah.
And
have you seen any pictures or anything on that yet? Okay, I
haven't
either.
I haven't. But I look forward to sitting down with the school administration and determining if there's going to be a possibility for Ellic City Arts to utilize that auditorium, the existing auditorium, or what the plans are.
Because I think they're looking at completion December 2025,
right,
which is not that far off. No. And they are working hard, but I ran into a lot of rock over there. We got a lot of rock around here. You just get to digging for something, you'll find it.
I put it on my calendar for December 2025 so that I can see if it happens or not.
Okay,
you never know. With construction projects, never know.
You've been through that yourself, ain't you?
Personally, yes. And at UAB, I was in charge of construction for a lot of different projects.
I didn't realize that.
Well, as facilities manager, I was.
I'm a darn. Well, you saw some changes up there, didn't
you? I did. I still see changes. At first, when I would go back through the campus, I would see buildings that were on the drawing boards when I was there. And now I'm seeing buildings that weren't even on the drawing board.
When I go to that campus, I'm lost.
Yeah, oh yeah.
I mean, I don't know which way to go.
Well, they'll show you. We'll be right back. Lake Martin, Dadeville Area Chamber of Commerce. Believe it or not, I got something right on top of my stack right here. Lake Martin, after hours meet and greet hosted by the Funky Goat, Thursday, May the 28th from 5 to 6:30. I know we had Trey Foshi out here yesterday and the lovely Bridget Thornhill to talk about this. And how do you become a member of the Lake Martin, Dadeville Area Chamber of Commerce? It's easy. Call this number, 256-825-4019.
King Honda Car World kicks off 2024 with an unbeatable selection of new Hondas available now for immediate delivery. Experience great products and incredible selection and fantastic prices on all of our new Honda inventory in stock. Our goal this month is to make it a month to remember by offering year-end deals at the start of the year. That way you get the best savings on any Honda in stock. Need to trade in your car? We're offering top dollar for quality trades, making your deal even better. Plus, this month only, enjoy free leather upgrades on all Honda Accord EX models. And we've got plenty in stock. Thank you for making 2023 our best year ever, and we're excited for an even better 2024.
Thank you all for a great 2023. I welcome the opportunity to meet you in person at our Honda store, where I know our staff will take great care of you. We hope to see you soon.
Visit our new facility at 2332 U.S. Highway 280 and start enjoying your new 2024 Honda this year.
The Rockford Pharmacy is now open Monday through Friday from 9 until 5. They're located across from Triple R Cafe in downtown Rockford. Go by and meet Leanne Armstrong and the friendly staff or give them a call at 256-377-9002.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
As your State Farm team, we will be there for you with the financial strength to deliver on our promises. Service that's a sure thing. You can think of us as your good neighbors who help protect what's important to you. We're here when you need us the most. You can call us 24/7 to get answers to your questions, file a claim, or see if we can find you more ways to save. We have many coverages and many discounts. We can help protect more areas of your life and find every discount you qualify for along the way. Please call us or visit 2048 Cherokee Road for coverage you can count on.
Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union, is looking for the next hometown hero. Hometown heroes could be first responders, public service workers, community leaders, pastors, community volunteers, or anyone who is making a difference in your hometown. Submit your nominations now online at myhscu.com. And if your nominee is selected, they will get a $100 Visa cash card and a certificate of appreciation from Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union. Federally insured by the NCUA.
The Rockford Pharmacy is now open Monday through Friday from 9 until 5. They're located across from Triple R Cafe in downtown Rockford. Go by and meet Leanne Armstrong and the friendly staff or give them a call at 256-377-9002.
Hi, this is Brian Bice with Bice Motors. With our all-star lineup of Dodge trucks, Jeep, SUVs, and Chrysler cars, we offer the area a team dedicated to making your next vehicle purchase a positive experience. Our sales team offers competitive pricing, and we back up all sales with the service department second to none. Bice Motors also offers the area's best selection of pre-owned vehicles. Visit Bice Motors at 2133 Cherokee Road in Alexander City.
We've talked about paying it forward this morning, which I think is a great thing. But when you have somebody that texts you and asks you to pay it forward, Chuck Bradley, that's not the way this pay it forward works.
Good morning, Chuck.
Got a big auction coming up, the second annual spring auction on Highway 9 in Alex City, coming up the 13th of next month. So put that on your things, dude. He'll be out here. Two people will be out here on April Fool's Day, which I think is very fitting. We're going to start out that day with, he's fool, I know that. I know Chuck Bradley's one of them. I'll think of it in just a little bit, but right now we got Miss Mary Perry out here. Got a cancellation, and we do have one coming up next month.
We do. They were going to be pretty close together if we had had the concert on March 21st, like we'd planned, but we're postponing it to May 7th. Mm-hmm. So the next thing that Alex City Arts will be presenting is the Alabama Troubadours.
That's
a band of four seasoned musicians who've come together, and they perform the music of John Prine.
You and I just agreed on the same thing, and it surprised me with you. I thought you would know John Prine really.
But I didn't. Heard the name is all.
John Prine passed away, was it last year, year before last?
It's been a short time, yes.
And when it hit the airwaves, people came out of the woodwork, and maybe his music even picked up. I personally didn't even know John Prine.
No, but I got to go see the Alabama Troubadours perform at the Alice Stevens Center last year, and they do a really good job of John Prine's music.
Was it songs that you knew?
Several were, but sounded familiar, yes.
And it's four of them?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. All play instruments?
Yes, okay. I think they all did.
They all
One time or the other.
They all harmonized
together. Yes,
really.
I do. There's three men and one girl. I don't have the names off the top of my head, but I will get them for you.
So it's coming up April next
April 6th. Okay. That's a Saturday night. We've not done many concerts on the weekends, but we're doing that one on Saturday night, April 6th.
At Benjamin Russell.
At CAC.
Okay.
At the Betty Carroll Graham Center. Okay. Yes.
Are the acoustics, and I know maybe this is maybe putting you on the spot, but do you like the acoustics better in Betty Carroll Graham Technology Center versus Benjamin Russell, or are both of them kind of?
If I had to say,
yeah.
I would say I know. They're a little bit better at Benjamin Russell.
Really?
I agree with you.
Because of the structure of the auditorium, the walls are created with that sound.
The Betty Carroll Graham Center works fine.
It does work fine.
I prefer the Benjamin Russell acoustics.
And that surprises me. I guess because I would, Benjamin Russell's a whole lot older, and I would thought the acoustics, because to get acoustics right, and you know this better than anybody, to get acoustics right in a building, it takes some designing, quilts hanging down. I mean, you know, to really get
something to bounce off of.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But, you know, in defense of the Betty Carroll
I wasn't knocking it.
It wasn't designed for performances.
For concerts. Yeah. It's a flat floor room.
Yeah.
Rectangular or almost squarish room with a stage.
And it works great for what it's designed for.
But we bring our own sound system.
Okay.
In both places. Mm-hmm. But to amplify, but in Benjamin Russell, you could do a non.
Yeah, you could. You could. Your voice would carry
amplified
there.
Sound.
A sound man. You agree? Which one you enjoy doing your sound in?
Yeah, probably
Benjamin
Russell.
Okay. Benjamin Russell.
But now
the floor pattern, like Mary said.
That's right.
Okay. All right, the floor, because Benjamin Russell kind of goes down.
It's a sloped floor.
Okay, I just learned.
Yeah, but the theater at CAC was a very good facility to use.
The small one,
that's
that they're renovating now.
That's correct.
Okay, okay.
You know, I've had the pleasure of doing several plays in that venue. You could talk there with no mic. You didn't have to be mic'd. Mm-hmm. It was fun.
And so much, how can folks join y'all? What do you need?
Patronage is available to anybody at different levels. Mm-hmm. And we're probably going to change that up for this next season, the 24-25 season, because LA City Arts is broadening its scope. Mm-hmm. We are pulling in the spoken word, which is an art form, and we're also bringing in visual arts. So,
explain to me what spoken word is.
Lectures. Storytelling.
Okay.
Narrations.
Mm-hmm. One person.
One-man shows.
That's right, one-person productions.
I've got somebody.
Like FDR, if you've never seen that, you need to see that. It's a one-man production. Guy walks out portraying Franklin Roosevelt.
Like the guy Einstein
came
last.
I liked him.
He was great.
Yeah.
And
he was different.
He was different.
Oh, and by the way, today's Einstein's birthday.
Oh, is it?
It sure is.
What?
314, as a matter of fact.
I know what day it is.
I'm messing with you.
He's in this pie thing. 314.
See, today's 314. I mean, you
know, today's pie day.
Oh, 314.
There ain't one pie day. And I told you a while ago, it's Hosea Poe, Miss Pie. That's on pie. That's P-I-E day.
But see, I'm full of useless knowledge.
Boy, you are. That's a real good way to clean it up right there, I'm telling you. But, you know, I go back to... you're talking about a one-man show. Will Rogers is one of my heroes, just the way he told stories, and that's what he did.
Mm-hmm.
Just went around the United States.
That's what I did.
He would tell a short story.
Well, short is an interpretation. Before we get away from here, we get off on the wrong thing, Mayor. What changes are you looking at changing or making in the LA City Arts for next year?
Well, we
started and then we got off.
Yeah, you remember there was a lecture series that used to run here called Horizons Unlimited. And when COVID happened, they kind of quit.
You'd have
And we're starting a series of lectures, daytime lectures, for people who want to come out.
Oh, wow.
And so we'll be doing that through the summer. And then we're also combining forces with the Sarah Carlisle Towery Alabama Art Colony.
Wow. And is that going to be 2024?
Yes.
Okay.
We'll start it in 24 and go into 25.
Got you something else to get involved in. Thank you for coming out here.
Well, thank you.
We'll try to get it maybe 7 or 7:30 next
time. Oh, I wouldn't count on that. Just get it warmer. That's all I care about.
You have a good day. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Let me tell you about Coon's Corner, Debbie. What is for lunch today? Let's see. Let's start off with some spaghetti casserole, roasted baby potatoes, mixed greens, black-eyed peas, green beans, cream corn, fried okra, and bread pudding. That's at Coon's Corner Deli today.
For over 80 years, the staff members of Radney and Langley Funeral Home have been friends in time of need, and we are dedicated to honoring, sharing, and preserving the amazing and inspirational stories of life. You've got a friend.
Obituaries brought to you by our friends at Radney Funeral Home and Langley Funeral Home. Funeral service for Mr. Andy Avery McAllister, 87 in Alexander City, were held yesterday, and Radney Funeral Home was in charge of that service. To the McAllister family and to other families that have lost loved ones, my heart goes out to each and every one of you. To the men and women that are fighting for our freedom, God bless you. God bless the USA, and we'll be right back.
Whether it's Lake Martin, Lay Lake, or Logan Martin, boaters from all over the state of Alabama come to Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama, because it's worth the drive. With the best deals on unbeatable Suzuki outboards, Manitou and Landau tritunes, and a great pre-owned inventory while they last, Alex City Marine is the pros the locals know. And no matter where you're from, when you're here, you're local to us. Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama. AlexCityMarine.com.
Arise is public transportation from downtown Alexander City. Now, from downtown Alexander City, they cover a 20-mile radius. Those vans are all over the place. When was the last time you went to see that friend? When was the last time you really needed to go to the doctor, but you didn't have a ride? Well, now you got one. It's Arise. Remember this. It's public transportation. Their number to call is 256-329-8444.
Have you been to Sure Shot Outdoors lately? Owner Scott Watson invites you to come in and take a peek at everything they have to offer. Not only do they carry the products you need, whether you're a beginner or an experienced shooter, their experienced staff offers both knowledge and the service you deserve. They also carry apparel, grills, coolers, and much more. Come on in and browse Sure Shot Outdoors today, your one-stop shop for all things outdoors. Located on Highway 280 in Alex City.
Grace's Flowers in Alexander City on Hillaby Street has been making people happy for decades. Susie Kelly and her friendly staff continue that same great tradition. Grace's Flowers is a full-service florist for all occasions, funerals, weddings, and other special events. In addition to flowers, Grace's has a great gift selection as well. To send a smile or encouragement, call 234-4238, and Grace's Flowers will deliver. Grace's Flowers on Hillaby Street in Alexander City.
Jeremy Worthy with Worthy Plumbing and Construction is carrying on a great family tradition, proudly serving the Lake Martin area and doing new construction, plumbing repairs, remodels, and a whole lot more. So keep this number handy, 205-936-4705. That's Worthy Plumbing and Construction. Again, the number to call is 205-936-4705. That's Mr. Jeremy Worthy.
Announcing Lake Martin Medical Center's new address at 815 Lee Street. Dr. Basil Rafai offers services in primary care, provides bioidentical hormone pelleting, and specializes in treating leg sores in the Lake Martin and surrounding areas. Our med spa also offers IPLs, laser hair removal, and a variety of aesthetic products and procedures for your skincare needs. We're your one-stop shop to looking and feeling your best. Call 256-212-9300 to schedule your appointment. That's 256-212-9300.
With the new year ringing in, Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor is ready for your lawn and tractor needs. With a great selection of new and used Mahindra tractors and implements or Spartan mowers. And we're not just selling, we're buying. We'll buy your used tractor, car, truck, boat, motorcycle, even if you're not buying from us. And we pay on the spot. Whatever your tractor or mower needs, Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor is doing business and paying on the spot. Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor, Highway 280 across from Home Depot.
O'clock on a Thursday morning, and one day before it hits the streets, I'm talking about Dan Adams, Life and Depth, out here with Suzanne Schultz. My day has been made. They're smiling over there.
Yeah.
How the heck are you?
Good. Good to be here again.
Tell us about this, because you've got some takes on this, don't you?
Yes. So we wrote together, and so there's a few songs on the record that he and I wrote together. Cat Hunter wrote with us, and Hunter Reynolds on a couple of them. We sang together on one, Lucky Ones, which we did last time we were here.
Yep.
On Valentine's Day, we did Lucky Ones, which is a Bonnie Bishop song. I love that song. What album is this for you?
So the album, this is my 10th album.
Wow.
Since the late 90s when I started making records. And
didn't know that.
I went through a divorce a couple years ago. Mm-hmm. And this album, kind of the early songs I started writing for this record were in the aftermath of that. So there's a lot of dark songs on it. Honestly.
Life and Depth.
Yeah, right. But, you know, then within the process of that, I met Suzanne and we started dating. And so there's also some hopeful stuff on the record as well. But it's
like the Lucky Ones.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, the title, people talk about, you know, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. I don't, maybe that's true, or I don't know if that's true or not, but when you're in the middle of it, it's, you know, the title for the record was basically how it get, you know, going through hard things gives you perspective.
Sure.
You know, different than what you had when things were good. So it's,
well, and also you were grieving. Your mom died with COVID.
Yeah.
It was one of the horrific deaths.
Wow.
Like in the hospital, and they couldn't go in. And it was a couple, it wasn't just a couple months after that their divorce happened. I mean, it was just a really, when you talk about one of the worst years of your life, he had one that year and all those
in
songs.
2022, yeah.
Yeah, all those songs. But he met me at the end of it. I was I was like, well, there's a silver lining.
Right, exactly.
Yeah,
but making the record was therapy for me, basically.
Yeah, and there's light in the darkest versions of your life. I love the album cover, right? How beautiful that cover. I mean, I love everything about this album. His the artwork, he did all that.
Light at the end of the tunnel.
I mean, how you feel like you are drowning, but, you know, you always have a choice to keep swimming.
Let me ask you something, Dan.
Yeah.
Going through that, did you look, you know, I'm sure you got way down.
Oh, yeah.
Did you look around and see people that maybe had an amputated leg that couldn't see, that was a whole lot worse than you said?
Absolutely.
You know what? I don't have any problem. Did things like that help you?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. And, you know, it's good to have people around you that love you too, you know, show up during a time like that.
Yeah.
And but absolutely, we go through stuff and kind of get in the middle of our own head, you know, and then we look around and maybe, you know, like you say, maybe there's other people that are going through worse things. So.
Attitude.
Absolutely.
I think 90% of it is attitude.
I'm with you 100% on it. And I think about attitude, even with people that get sick.
Yeah.
If they've got a good attitude. Yeah. I think about my buddy, Elliot Moon. Buddy, hope you're doing well today. Recently had a leg amputated, but he's got the attitude. He said, I'm a champion. He said, I'm ready to open my car wash. So, you know, it's all about attitude. I don't care what it has, even with a child.
Yeah.
Even with older folks. Yeah. It's all about attitude.
Yeah. If you can reframe your mind to see hope and positivity, I really think that that's why the good news exists and why it's called the good news is like you really do want to experience, you want to be hopeful. So there's always that, and having people around you who point you to hope.
And having something, you know, that's another thing about making, you know, any kind of art, in this case music, having something to focus your energy on that gives you direction and purpose in the middle of something like that.
The other nine albums, did you have that same,
you know,
mindset?
It's, I mean,
how many did you do while you were in Nashville?
Gosh, it's I did maybe three or four records in Nashville.
Okay.
And it, you know, every album's different. I mean, the creative inspiration and the creation, the process of recording, it's different every time. I have, you know, for years worked in studios in Nashville and in Muscle Shoals and in Austin. And then
you're blowing my mind.
Well, the last couple of records I've done in my home studio. And that, you know, that's a whole different experience because I can be, you know, when you're in a studio, you're on the clock and you're paying for every minute you're there. And when you're at working at home, you can really devote more time and you can try things that you might not try if you were in a studio. And so it's, you know, it's a different creative process.
You mind talking about that? I'm talking about let's go to Nashville or any place. You go in a studio, number one, you're paying for that time in that studio. You're paying for the artists that are in there. If you got a guitar player, you got somebody singing a harmony or whatever, you're paying for those.
Absolutely.
They're not just showing up.
That's right. Yeah, and it's very expensive. Yeah. You know, it's expensive to make records, and the business has changed a lot in the last 20 or 25 years, where the money that you used to could make on the back end of making a record has dwindled and dwindled and dwindled. I mean, because people don't buy physical product anymore for the most part. So the profit margins on what you're selling is much, much narrower now. So it's, it doesn't cost any less to make a record now than it did 20 years ago, but there's a whole lot less money to be made, you know, on the back end.
What do you tell a young person that's just, they're just biting at the bits to get, I'm going to say natural again, to get there and do everything you're talking about? They need to really think about what they're fixing to get into.
Yeah, I mean, I think my biggest advice, the biggest thing I learned was to be a student of the business and learn as much as you can outside your own creative process and the art piece of it, to be as knowledgeable as you can about the business part of it and how studio time works and working with musicians and how labels work and publishing and all those things that are part of the industry. The more you can educate yourself and read and talk to people in the business.
Be as professional.
Absolutely.
I mean, Dan is so professional. I mean, like, he's the on time. He's the early. Today, we were really late, and I had stressed him all the way out because we were 5 minutes early, and that is late to him. And I was like, oh, we're almost not going to be late. He's like, absolutely not acceptable. But he's so professional in everything that he does. And I think if you're going to Nashville, you better have already shored up that part of you where you are professional. You can work well with others. You play well with others. You have your skill set is at the highest that you feel like you could professionally be a musician, writer, whatever. You're disciplined because Nashville... Nashville is going to use you up and destroy you. And if you are not like committed and disciplined in a professional, you are going to, it's not going to work out well for you. It's just not.
Let me add one thing there. I know very little about the music business, but everything that Suzanne Schultz just said, you folks, I'm over here again, I don't care what age you are, if that's something that's in your dreams, there's a lot of sharks. I'm picking on Nashville right now, but anywhere in the there's a lot of sharks. Yep. They're gonna promise you the world. They gonna paint you this prettiest picture you've ever seen. You fixing to be a star. Well, you better step back before that a star comes a falling down, and you've spent tens of thousands of dollars, and you ain't got nothing to show.
That's right.
Then you go back to those same people that were gonna make you a star. Can't find them.
That's right.
Oh yeah.
I mean, you know, so a lot,
exactly right.
So a lot of people around here, what musicians around, maybe young musicians are fresh off the boat musicians, they pay people in Nashville to record songs for them, and they get a product for a good little dollar, and it is not what they wanted, not what they thought. It's not as good. I mean, you know, and that happens all the time here, and they think that they just got a Nashville-produced song, and it's just...
She's telling you.
It's unfortunate.
You better be listening. Don't go anywhere. We're going to hear some music when we come back. Oh, let me tell you about Cloud Nine. In fact, I'm not going to make it by that day, but tomorrow I'm going by and see Miss Amanda. But I want y'all to go by today. Cloud Nine, downtown Alexander City. Easter is right around the corner. I keep saying Easter, but maybe you want to buy an outfit like this right here. Mom, and I always mention mom and daughter, because she's really working hard to make sure that she has the clothes in there for both or all ages. Go by and see for yourself today. Cloud Nine, downtown Alexander City.
At Beyond Home Care, we provide in-home care services to individuals needing assistance with activities in their daily lives. We work with each client to provide personalized home care and sitter services, whether it's assistance with bathing and personal care or an escort to a doctor's appointment. Each client receives the individual care they need with the dignity and respect they deserve. Give us a call today at 256-414-6090 or visit us online at beyondhomecareal.com.
The Morris Haynes Law Firm focuses on representing those who have been injured or mistreated by the wrongful acts of others. We have offices in Ellic City and Birmingham, but we have been calling Ellic City home for over 30 years. If you find yourself in need of a lawyer, give us a call at Morris Haynes, 256-329-2000. We would be honored to help you.
Lake Martin Mini Mall is geared up for spring with new inventory arriving daily. See our huge selection of big green eggs and accessories, along with our expanded lines of high-density Daybreak outdoor furniture and complete solar lighting kits for home, patio, decks, and docks. Lake Martin Mini Mall is also excited to announce our local farmers and artisan market starting March 23rd, offering farm-fresh vegetables and foods. Shop Tuesday through Saturday and mark March 23rd on your calendar for our spring kickoff party.
Music Depot, located next to Depot Gun and Pond on Highway 280 in Alexander City, is stocked and ready for you to visit. Huge inventory of quality name drums, amps by Glaney and Fender, electric and acoustic guitars, pianos, fiddles, every accessory you need for yourself or band. Before you shop out of town, shop Music Depot on Highway 280 in Alexander City. Call 256-234-6767.
At CNT Electric, our clients are our priority. For the safety and security of your family and home, our technicians are professionally trained, drug tested, background checked, and wear uniforms with name tags. We're proud to have served the Ellic City, Dadeville, and Lake Martin areas for the past 10 years. Give us a call at 256-234-0007 for all your electrical service and repair needs. Or visit us on the web at www.cntelectricllc.com and spell out the word AND.
Satterfield Outdoor Living is Lake Martin's trusted friend for your outdoor land and leisure needs. We're the region's authorized Skag mower dealer for residential and commercial lawns and offer all the small engine accessories you need. With top lines of Steel, Echo, Shindaiwa, Husqvarna, and Metabo products that can tame any landscape. Satterfield is also your grill headquarters with Big Green Egg Grill, and our pros service everything in-house and back up all sales. Get the Satterfield Outdoor Difference on Highway 280 right across from Tallapoosa Ford.
You dreamed about the perfect house, a place to call your own, and a place to not only stretch out, but to grow. Auto Owners protects your house because to you, it's home. That's simple human sense.
Happy to help, man. I was just over there talking to myself anyway.
Come back in here and join us. We're having way too much fun out here with Dan Adams, who's got a brand new album. I actually like to call them albums, coming out tomorrow, Life and Depth. And Suzanne Schultz has some cuts on that. You got some gigs coming up.
Yes, I have. I have the next two Saturdays I double booked because I'm an idiot. I also love to play, but this Saturday I'm at Bark at the Park at Kiesel Park. I'm for Auburn. They have a big party every year, yeah. Kind of bringing all the dogs out to Kiesel because it's a friendly dog park. So I'm playing for that. Dan's going to play with me on mm-hmm. Saturday there. And then Saturday night I'm at One More on the River in Millbrook. Okay. It's on the water. It's mm-hmm. such a cool spot for Sunday afternoon. Yeah. Saturday evening, 8 to 11. Mm-hmm. Next Saturday, I'm going to be at the Adam Russell Scholarship Foundation trail ride. And immediately after that, I'm leaving directly from that and going to the Lake Martin Mini Mall for their spring kickoff. Having the market now. Mm-hmm. And I'm so excited. I love all these people that I get to play for in the next mm-hmm. couple weeks. I adore Robin and I can't wait to be a part of that. And that's this really weekend fun. For Bark in the Park mm-hmm. at Auburn at Kiesel and One More on the River. So.
And what else you got?
Oh my gosh. Well, I'm like, tonight I'm at a I have a gig tonight at 7 o'clock tonight. I'll be at Coosa River Craft House in Wetumpka.
Okay.
So,
wow.
Today's going to be a long one, but it'll be fun.
The song you're fixing to do, mm-hmm. is this one you wrote? Is this one y'all wrote?
It's one we wrote. Okay. This is the title cut, and I had the album title throughout the process, and then this is one of the last songs that was written for the mm-hmm. record. We went up and did we've talked about our songwriting right. weekends in Mentone mm-hmm. in North Alabama at the mm-hmm. cabin. So it was Suzanne and I and Kat Hunter and Hunter Reynolds mm-hmm. For a weekend writing songs up there, and this is one of the last songs that we wrote. Just took the idea, that I explained about the album, and we fleshed that out into a song. So,
let me ask you something. You're talking about the recording in your studio uh-huh. now. Is that's happened so many times over the years? Music Row ain't much of a Music Row in Nashville.
Yeah,
they all those real famous places closed. But again, in recording, it's work.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
I mean, it's you go in there for a day. Let's just say an 8-hour day. That's a lot of stress.
It is, and working up there, like you mentioned earlier, a lot of times you're using session musicians mm-hmm. that are playing on the instruments. The majority of everything you hear on this record is I played. So like every instrument, there's I had some guest guys play on three or four of the songs. Individual, I had a guitar player that Dallas Dorsey from
Oklahoma. Oh, yeah, I know Dallas.
Dallas played guitar.
I love old Dallas.
He's
Dallas
awesome.
Is awesome. I love Dallas.
He played on one song, and Avery Anderson played fiddle on one song, and Sean Altman played pedal steel on a couple. Oh. But for the most part, what you hear, and of course, my bass player, Steve Bowers, lives in Nashville. He plays mm-hmm. on everything I do. Mm-hmm. But outside of that, everything you hear on the record is me playing. So.
Well, let me tell you, I want to thank both of y'all for coming out here. And I know it's a monthly, but it's just it's a front porch. It's where you sit and pick and carry on a conversation. Yep. And so the name of this song?
Life and Depth.
Life and Depth, the name of the album.
Yes, sir.
Comes out tomorrow.
Comes out tomorrow.
Out of the cold, clear blue, lost everything I knew. My world blew up and I didn't have a say. Forcing me to change my view on who am I and who are you. Was everything a lie to yesterday? What the hell am I supposed to do? Out here with no net, no parachute. I didn't know that I should hold my breath. Going that far under could have been my death. It don't make me any stronger trying to hold on any longer. So I let go, reach for the light that's left. It ain't over, but it ain't killed me yet. It's just a matter of life and death. One day at a time, less and less I'm living life. Broken man that you left behind. I know what I have to do. I don't need no net, no parachute. But I didn't know that I should hold my breath. Going that far under could have been my death. Didn't make me any stronger trying to hold on any longer. So I let go and reach for the light that's left. It's all over, but it ain't killed me yet. It's only life and death. I didn't know that I should hold my breath. Going that far under could have been my death. It didn't make me any stronger trying to hold on any longer. So I let go and reach for the light that's left. It's all over, but it ain't only life and death.
Good song.
I love that song.
Let me ask you something. So with that song right there, you got bass, you got fiddle, you got pedal steel in that song?
Yeah, it's a full production, yeah.
Wow. That's got to be a killer.
It's a good one.
Let me get a little personal with
okay.
both y'all. Has she made you a better person?
Absolutely. 100%.
Oh, he has way made me a better person.
Yeah,
same question. I almost get here on time now.
We're such a good fit. We really are.
We really are. We knew pretty early on. I was like, no, you're in the worst year of your life. We cannot get involved.
Yeah.
And he was like, yeah, we probably shouldn't. But both of us were like, God, it's so good.
Yeah.
Our music tastes and political.
Your honesty.
Yeah.
With each other. Right off the bat, it sounds like.
Yeah,
we're. It's a really good fit.
Good.
It's a lot of fun to be able to go and do I mean, both for both of us, music is such a passion, and so it's a lot of fun for to be able to share that
with
each other. Well, and how busy life is that God gave us to each other to be each other's person, because the only time we have are our gigs. Mm-hmm. Like, we both have day jobs, and he has a high day job, like a high value day job, and I have a day job, and we both have kids. Like, there's no room, but we have gigs, and I'm like, oh, you can gig with me, and I can gig
with you.
That ends
up being our dates.
That's literally like date night. I'm like, we get to date like two or three times a week. This is stupid. Like, none of my single friends that are my age, they get to date like once a month. They're like, I can schedule this. I'm like, no, my second job. He's a part of my second job, and I'm a part of his second job. It's actually unbelievable. It's shockingly good.
It's amazing how music works sometimes.
It is.
Especially in y'all's.
Yeah.
In y'all's case.
Yes. It is a gift and a curse and a gift.
Well, let me tell you something. But how can folks get this, Dan?
So it'll be on Apple Music, Spotify, all the online places, everywhere you stream music, it'll be available tomorrow.
What's after this?
After this, so I've been doing solo gigs, solo acoustic gigs and duo gigs with Suzanne for the last several years. And it's been a long time since I played with a band, but recently I put a band together, and we're going to start our first show as a band is at Commerce Beer Works on April the 20th in Montgomery. And I'm pretty excited to be doing a full band thing again.
Three piece.
Yeah. So a couple guys, I'm going to be playing acoustic and electric, kind of swapping off. And then I have a bass player that I've known, guy from Columbus that I've known for 25 years, and then a drummer that I just recently met.
And they'll be at the Loft, too. So that's coming up, too, the Loft in Columbus. So they're going to be playing all the big band places. Okay. I'm excited.
Thank y'all for coming out here.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having us again.
It comes out here tomorrow. Good timing on this, too.
Oh,
Dan
great.
Adams, Life and Death. Make sure you pick it up. Y'all have a great day. We'll be right back. Carlisle, downtown Alexander City. Well, you're looking for a place to go have a sandwich and maybe some soup today, or maybe just some conversation. And while you're there, you're going to eat, or maybe vice versa. Let me tell you something. Carlisle's been there since 1914. You've been there, but when was the last time you actually took time to go in there and patronize them? Today would be a good day. It's located on Main Street in downtown Alexander City.
OGS Tournaments presents Crank for Bank. Win over $1.6 million in cash and prizes. Over 200 tag bass and 75 tag crappie are waiting to be caught by you in Lake Martin. Register now online at crankforbank.com for only $120. All ages are welcome. Fish from the dock, boat, or the shores of Lake Martin to win over $1.6 million in cash and prizes. It's Crank for Bank.
For years, Tom Watley's been a name you can trust to represent you, and now you can depend on Tom Watley Law, LLC to handle all of your legal needs. Tom has over 20 years of practicing criminal defense, probate needs, and estate planning. Tom Watley Law supports the communities of Lee and Tallapoosa County and can handle all your legal needs or refer you to their network of specialty attorneys. When it counts, call Tom Watley Law, LLC at 334-559-3420 or online at tomwatleylaw.org. No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Hillaby Towers is an affordable senior citizens community located in Alexander City on Highway 22 East. Spacious one bedrooms are available now. Great location, peaceful setting, comfortable living where pets are allowed and utilities are included. Call today to find out more information on Alexander City's best kept secret, 256-329-0552. That's Hillaby Towers in Alexander City.
Medicare for Veterans, MedicareSalute.com. Medicare for Veterans, helping to maximize your VA, CHAMP VA, and TRICARE benefits. Call 256-675-5315 today. Ask for Amber Walker. Ask about Medicare, life, health, dental, and final expenses. Do that today. Call 256-675-5315.
Inspired by the bold bison, Southern Union students blaze new trails every single day. They press forward knowing their SU education will lead them to success. Affordable, accessible, and locally unparalleled. Whether you're transitioning to a university or launching straight into a lucrative career, a degree from SUSEC can help you blaze your path. Three locations, dedicated faculty and staff, endless possibilities. It's all waiting for you at Southern Union. It's time to venture forward. Register today.
At Fire Truck Barbecue in Alexander City.
Ooh, just for a taste, just for a taste. And you know that we're the place. Yeah,
yeah. Hungry for real Southern barbecue at its best? Just one taste is all it takes at Fire Truck Barbecue. Choose from their famous slow-smoked beef brisket, pulled pork, St. Louis-style ribs, smoked chicken, and more, complete with your favorite homemade side dishes and their famous peach cobbler for dessert. That's Fire Truck Barbecue, 226 Jefferson Street in Alexander City, and follow us on Facebook.
$500 over invoice now at Tony Serra Ford. Every new Ford on the lot, $500 over invoice when you trade in finance with Tony Serra Ford, plus 3.9% financing for 72 months. Save thousands on new F-150s and more, all backed by Serra's lifetime warranty. No charge. Every new Ford, $500 over invoice at Tony Serra Ford. In Sylacauga, TonySerraFord.com.
Seven 30 on a Thursday morning, so it must be time for the good doctor to come out here, Dr. Demo Popov, because 4 years ago yesterday, COVID hit, and he told us it was coming in February before. I'll never
he shared the truth with us.
I think it must be tumbleweeds must be getting together. That's what we use on Thursday night.
Yeah, y'all use it for a different reason.
Hearing the same old story. What is the bell for today, sir?
All right, well... this is a sequel to what we should and eat. Last time we talked a little bit about the artificial meat that they began to make, and we kind of pretty much the verdict was don't do it. Right. It's not healthy. It's not natural. I wouldn't recommend it. Then we covered really quickly onto all the arguments they're putting forward for you to start buying artificially created food, just like. The hole in the ozone layer and the CO2 emissions and global warming, climate change, and all that. And obviously, there's absolutely no scientific backing to this whatsoever. And again, one more time, CO2 constitutes 0.04% of the atmosphere. Human activity contributes 3% out of this 0.04. So technically, it makes absolutely no sense whatsoever that this in any form or fashion is contributing to the change of climate.
Right.
So, you know, arguments like that are kind of pretty much useless from scientific point of view, but they're targeted at you for you to change your behavior. And kind of to sum it all up, if anybody stands up over there somewhere and starts telling you don't drive internal combustion engines and start eating artificial meat, ignoring normal, regularly harvested meat. Mm-hmm. This is one big pile of stinky, nasty turd.
I'm with you. I'm with you. But is that just people just, they ain't got nothing else to do but to come up with stuff like that?
Well, they're looking for anything and everything. They're targeting anybody that may be interested in certain aspects of life to promote their cause, to push their product. And obviously, they invested a bunch of millions of dollars into their new products, and they're looking for somebody to buy it. Mm-hmm. So that's where we are. And if we turn a page, a new page, continuing in the same line, kind of several months ago, I watched one of the documentaries about the assassination of JFK. Mm-hmm. And then I saw that people were kind of slim and trim and very, very healthy looking. And I was kind of wondering, what happened in the meanwhile? Why are we the way we are now? If you look around, we have so much obesity, much disease mm-hmm. everywhere. Because if you look at it, the United States spends the most amount of money on healthcare comparing mm-hmm. to any other developed country. And our outcomes are actually far, far worse than any other developed country. Mm-hmm. But then later on, I saw another documentary, and that was The Foods That Built America.
I saw right. that.
Okay. And all that was fast food and candy. Mm-hmm. And then everything pretty much clicked. That's what came on in the 60s. Mm-hmm. That's what started making us sick. Mm-hmm. That's what really is responsible for what's going on.
Yes.
And I kind of going to go through a little bit in detail. Just one fact, and we will kind of leave the sugar down the road. We are eating now 400% more refined sugar mm. than 1964. Mm. 400%. But again, sugar is another topic. Fast food. And again, everybody knows fast food is bad for you. There's no question about it. Nobody would say, oh my God, I never heard of that anywhere. And even some people call that trash or junk food. Mm-hmm. And still people eat it. And I'm not really sure what do you need to call it, what do you need to label it for them to get the message, please don't do it. Mm-hmm. This is something that we're poisoning ourselves with, spending our hard-earned money on, and somehow nobody cares about it. And that's why I wanted to talk a little bit about it, just to give people an idea what really fast food is all about. Mm-hmm. Now, whenever they make a patty for hamburger or what have you, they make it somewhere far, far away. They need to package it, wait for the truck. Then whenever the truck comes, load it up to the truck, send it to Alex City. Then it goes in a freezer, and then it's made into, you know, whatever it needs to be, like a hamburger whenever somebody buys it. So you can imagine the shelf life of this hamburger has to be quite long. Mm-hmm. So the only way for them to extend it is putting a lot of preservatives in it, which is chemicals. Then the industry knows that people like salt, sugar, fat, and they put a lot of that in anything they make in that hamburger. Salt, sugar, fat. And since we love eating stuff like that, we in a way become addicted to it. Mm-hmm. And they know that, and we know that. So that's why people, although they know this is not good for you, but it's loaded up with the things that we love, so.
And we still do it.
And we do it. So, and that's not all.
Yeah.
As the whole industry has developed, as science has progressed, they realize they can get away with giving you low-quality meat and still being able to sell it to you because they have all different other types of new chemicals that can improve the color, the taste, the smell, the texture, and anything you can imagine. So whenever you end up buying a hamburger in any of the fast food places, what you're eating is a low-quality product which is loaded with all different type of chemicals. Most, if not all of them, will hurt you. Most, if not all of them, will give you cancer. Then you're going to be eating extra salt, sugar, and fat that will make you addicted. And you're going to be making a bunch of money to people who don't give a damn about your health.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's what really is happening. And you may say, well, is there anything else that is healthy? Well, how about Chick-fil-A? Well, let me tell you a little secret. In the bun of Chick-fil-A, there are 40 extra ingredients. 40.
Wow.
In the sandwich of Chick-fil-A, there are 100 extra ingredients. Mm-hmm. So if you think there's anything healthy in any fast food chain, yeah, you're hallucinating. Then you may say, well, how about the rest of the world? This is everywhere else. Yes, it is everywhere else, but that's the difference. In Australia, New Zealand, milk from the United States is banned because the hormones that's in it. Mm-hmm. Japan just banned Frosted Flakes because they contain BHT, which is a carcinogen, something that causes cancer. Mm-hmm. It is banned in China, legal in the United States. In Europe, they do have fast food chains. Yes, they do. But the French fries in McDonald's contain three and only three ingredients: potato, oil, salt. Mm-hmm. That is it. Mm-hmm. Here in the United States, they have a long, 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 long list of ingredients you cannot even pronounce. So why is it like that? Well, because there's no regulation. And if somebody tries to make regulation, well, I guess the fast food industry is powerful enough with a powerful lobby to kill anything.
Oh, wow.
And then if you think about, the pharmaceutical company has zero interest in regulating anything because what they need is they need people to buy their drugs. Mm-hmm. And if you paid attention to what's going on in the TV, the majority of the commercials that you see nowadays are for drugs. So pretty much in a roundabout way, they're telling you, we know you're coming, and that's what you're gonna need whenever you come. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it sounds like a conspiracy theory, but if you put two and two together, it kind of sounds true.
If you don't want to call it conspiracy theory, it certainly sounds like a marketing theory.
Yeah, and again, they market it, they make you, want to buy it because it looks great and looks cool and yada, yada, yada. And you just look at the cigarettes, the way they were promoted and so on and so forth, the way they were kind of manipulated, the nicotine levels to increase the addiction potential and yada, yada, yada. The same thing, you know,
that's right.
Carbon copy, no difference. Mm-hmm. So what do you do? The question is, what do you do? What do you eat? Last time we touched a little bit about it, eat anything that is as close to its natural state as possible. Close to the natural, non-GMO, not genetically modified, mm-hmm. not created artificially somewhere, mm-hmm. just like fruit and vegetables. Fresh markets, go some of the farmers markets. In Auburn, there's one big one. There's a guy that comes from Auburn here every Saturday to sell some of that.
He's telling it like it is. We'll be right back.
Triple R Cafe. We talk about good food. There is great food at Triple R Cafe, and they're working on it right now. You need to load up, go to Triple R Cafe, go in for lunch today, and be ready to go back this weekend for, they'll have maybe steaks over the weekend, or just go by and see them for breakfast maybe Saturday morning. Triple R Cafe, tell Matthew Reams and the entire staff, we said hello. Where do you find it? In the capital city of Coosa County, downtown Rockford.
Alex City Internal Medicine and Nephrology and Weight Loss Center provides optimum care for the whole person. Dr. Dimo Popov specializes in the prevention and diagnosis of high blood pressure, kidney disease, diabetes, and acute and chronic conditions. Our weight loss clinic offers lipo shots and a guide to healthy weight loss. Alex City Internal Medicine and Nephrology and Weight Loss Center, where lifestyle changes are made.
Benton Clearing and Grading is Cody and A.O.D. Benton, and they got your job in sight. Moving dirt is a clean job to them. Clearing a lot for your home or business is what they do, and they do it right. Call A.O.D. or Cody today at 256-397-2531 or 397-2532 for a quote today. I promise you, they'll do the job right. That's Benton Clearing and Grading.
Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation is coming soon to the corner of 280 and 49 North in Dadeville. This new 10,000 square foot facility is conveniently located to serve the residents of the Lake Martin area and its many communities. A branch of Frederick Dean Funeral Home and Crematory in Opelika, Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation looks forward to serving your families and your communities, as we have since 1900 at Frederick Dean. 256-750-0381.
With numerous industrial sites across the area, first-class workforce development initiatives, and a business-friendly climate, Tallapoosa and Coosa counties have just what your company needs to be successful. To find out more, visit lakemartineda.com or call 256-215-4404 to speak to Executive Director Denise Walls. Let us make it work for you. Call 256-215-4404.
I'm used to living alone, taking care of myself, Mr. Independent. But every now and then, I need a little help. My kids aren't close, and I want to stay in my own home. As close as family is such a godsend. Caring professionals here to help me with all the little things. Taking care of the house and myself, keeping me looking sharp. Feeling sharp, too.
Learn more at asclosesfamily.com.
They really are as close as family.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our nine locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
The food at Oscar's Cafe makes your mouth water. At Oscar's, enjoy great-tasting catfish, or maybe you're just in the mood for one of Oscar's fresh salads. Even kids know the place for a fine meal is Oscar's with a great kids menu. Oscar's also has great-tasting burgers full of backyard flavor. So come on out to Oscar's Cafe for great food and homegrown hospitality. We're located on Highway 49 South in Dadeville, just before the Blue Creek Bridge. And remember, it's all fun and games till there's only one cheese ball left.
Folks, it's 48 degrees outside. It's going to be 80 degrees today with no rain. That increases tonight by a 30% chance of rain, low of 60. It increases tomorrow to 100% chance of rain, mid-70s for a high, low to mid-50s for a low tomorrow night. And then Saturday, pretty much cleaned up, no rain, 73 and 50. Slight chance of rain on Sunday, 69 and 42. 60 Monday and Tuesday and in the 30s. Starting out a pretty nice week. There's your five-day forecast brought to you by
Top Gun Pest Control, Highway 280 in Alexander City.
Dr. Demo Popov with us out here this morning. Tell it like it is, brother. He brought the bell to prove it.
Yes. Well, the one thing I want to start second segment is, you know, the groundhog, he admitted he lied.
Yeah, he did.
But anyhow, we were talking about how to get some healthy food, fruit and produce. Again, farmer's market in Auburn off the highway. There's one big one. There's a guy that comes over there from that market, buys stuff, and comes to Alex City every Saturday, right next to Welburn Museum. During the summertime, we do have a farmer's market. Buy stuff there. The closest you can buy to the place where it was made, it was picked, the better off you are. And again, I made one other observation, kind of food for thought. If you go in the supermarket, you will see apples all the same size, the same shape, same color. Mm-hmm. Whenever you go to the farmer's market, you're going to see the apples, different sizes, different shapes, different shades of color. That's how nature makes them. Nature does not make them even, absolutely even, one point. And the other.
No thought so about that.
This is, you know, if you want to buy something that's natural, that was picked in the garden the way mm-hmm. it was made, mm-hmm. that's what you look for. And again, that's where we buy the apples from that farmer's market. A little ding here and there, a little scratch here mm-hmm. and there. That's okay. Mm-hmm. That's how it came. That's nature. Mm-hmm. So that's how you buy fruit and vegetables. And people say, how about organic? Yes, organic is interesting as a concept. Mm-hmm. The problem with that is USDA was just sued because it is labeling produce coming from different countries as organic with next to no oversight. So in other words, I'm not sure if a lot of money exchanged hands or what really happened, but if the USDA goes to a different country and inspects one particular area once and that's it, mm-hmm. imagining that this will continue forever and ever, and labels it organic, this is inappropriate. Mm-hmm. So that's why this is the lawsuit. So if anything is labeled by USDA as anything, I wouldn't believe it. Second thing, you know, I talked to a manager from Whole Foods, mm-hmm. And they told me that they have the stickers, the organic stickers. So whenever the pallets arrive with different apples and whatever it is, mm-hmm. they put them randomly anywhere they want to put them. Mm-hmm. And since organic will cost them more, guess what? What you're buying may nothing to do with organic produce. Wow. Mm-hmm. So that sticker organic may not mean anything. Mm-hmm. So that's why buy from the people that you know will give you organic stuff. Farmers Market.
Farmers Market here will start Memorial Day weekend and go through Labor Day weekend. It's something that's growing. It's going to be on Calhoun Street this year, like 7 to 11 every Saturday. And it's a good way to, number one, get out and see folks, but leave yep. with bag full yes. of yes. good products. Good
food. Support quality people. Food. Because, again, there's advertisement on TV, but if you make up your own mind and want to eat healthy and want to eat better, the industry will notice and put more stuff like that out there on the market. Mm-hmm. Now, meats. We talked a little bit about meats last time. Try to do meat that is kind of, is described as no antibiotics, no hormones. Mm-hmm. It should be on the label. Now, grass-fed beef has become an issue, which is very important. It's kind of the healthiest. And yes, you can find it. We researched it in Georgia. There's one place which advertises it as grass-fed, grass-finished. And that's a very important distinction because a lot of farms will do corn fed grass mm-hmm. finished. Grass finished means for about a week before they're slaughtered, they give them grass. That's completely meaningless. Mm-hmm. If you eat a lot of corn, you're getting an obese animal. Mm-hmm. You're eating a fat animal. So that's not really very healthy. The grass fed grass finished is what you need to buy.
Does it come on the package that way?
It does. If you research the place and you buy it from that place, right. mm-hmm. they advertise it, it comes like that. Mm-hmm. If you buy it in the store, USDA may certify it as grass-fed, but they do not distinguish between grass-fed and grass-finished. Mm-hmm. For them, if you've given them a week of grass, to them this is grass-fed. In other words, again, USDA certificate for anything is completely worthless. Mm-hmm. Okay, so find a place, a local butcher that you know, that they tell you the what we're slaughtering in the slaughterhouse, this is grass-fed, grass-finished. So that's what you want to buy.
Blair Family Farm up in Ashland, right. they do that. They have that. And they've been on the show and talked about that, the way they process their hogs and their cattle. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So then they'll talk about a steak in just a regular supermarket. It's not good.
Yeah. So again, these are the things that you may want to look at mm-hmm. In terms of what to eat. And then people will say, well, what breakfast do I have? You know, if you go into specifics, mm-hmm. maybe one or two eggs. That should be fine, the toast, mm-hmm. that should be fine.
Protein.
If you want to get an oatmeal, mm-hmm. that should be fine. I want to break a heart here and there. The most highly processed food out there on the market? Cereals.
Mm-hmm.
This is one of the worst things that you can ever have. So stay away from that. Oatmeal is better.
Mm-hmm. So how about yogurt?
Yogurt is excellent. Okay. You can get maybe a yogurt, some of the Greek yogurts. You can get an apple together with it. That should be fine.
I love yogurt and putting my big thing there is blackberries. Big old fat blackberries, okay, or blueberries.
That is good. Again, one little caveat over okay here. Buy stuff which is in season.
Right, yeah, yeah.
If it
yeah
is not in yeah season, it's coming from a land far, far, far all away.
Right, okay.
And actually, for example, the strawberries, if strawberries are not in season, they're coming from God knows where.
Mm-hmm.
For them to last in your refrigerator for weeks and weeks, they treat it, irradiate mm-hmm it. So buy stuff in season and wash them really well.
What a segment. What a yeah segment. Listen to the man. We'll be right back and wrap it up. Watch Curb Market, located on Davil Road, right here in Alexander City. Watch Curb Market will have a lunch today with a soup or sandwich fresh made right there by the girls. Coming in April, I'll tell you more about that coming up in April. Watch Curb Market, Davil Road.
It's truck season at Glenn Smith Chevrolet in Opelika. Check out the powerful full-size and fully loaded Chevrolet Silverado LTZ, discounted up to $11,000 off, or the roomy midsize three-row SUV, the Chevy Traverse, discounted up to $7,750 off, and the perfect size Chevy Equinox up to $7,750 off. No payments until summertime. Over 350 new and used vehicles on the lot or on the way.
Get ready to smile.
Hello, my name is Charlie Kuykendall. I'm the Minister of Music and Senior Adults here at First Baptist Church in Dadeville, and I am so excited about the Easter season. On Easter Sunday morning, that's March 31st, at 8:15 and 11 o'clock, you have an opportunity to come and worship, celebrate the risen Savior with us. We are looking forward to a wonderful day of praise and worship to our risen Savior that day. Come and join us.
Carlisle Heating Air says it's tune-up time for your HVAC system. Having your unit tuned up increases energy efficiency and can reduce the wear and tear on your unit. Call Carlisle Heating Air Day at 256-234-0019 for a price. Serving the Lake Martin area, Alexander City, Dayville, Jackson Gap, and Goodwater. Don't get hot, be cool. Call Carlisle Heating and Air today at 256-234-0019. Don't get hot, be cool.
For those who missed Zaxby's Egg Rolls the first time, these hand-rolled bundles of deliciousness are back. Just in time to take a sweet and spicy dip. Yes, you heard that right. Two for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's. Egg rolls are back at Zaxby's. They're hand-rolled and come with a delicious sweet and spicy dipping sauce. But enough from me. Let the egg rolls do the talking. And there you have it. Two for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.
Wintertime in the South is mild compared to other parts of the country, but we still tend to be less active and spend more time indoors. Show your heart some love this winter by getting it checked out at the UAB Heart and Vascular Clinic at Russell Medical. I'm Dr. Kevin Sublett, and our entire clinic is dedicated to keeping your heart healthy. We're right here in your own community and backed by the knowledge and expertise of UAB Medicine. Make an appointment today by calling 256-234-2644 or visit uabmedicine.org/heartrussell.
While in Dayville, Alabama, get off the roundabout and stop in Payne's Furniture. Donald Payne says right now the selection of couches with end tables is unbelievable. Comfortable bedding, rustic bedding, area rug selection like he's never had. Beautiful dining tables, modern and rustic. Ask him about financing. Or if you want to call him at 256-825-7727. That's Payne's Furniture in downtown Dayville.
Tapley Appliance is now Presley Appliance and Furniture. It's all the same friendly staff. And Mike and Trevor Presley not only offer the best in appliances from Whirlpool, KitchenAid, and Maytag, but now we offer full lines of furniture from Ashley, as well as a great selection of outdoor furniture. Make sure to visit the Presley family at the all-new Presley Appliance and Furniture on Cherokee Road in Alex City. Same great service and appliances, now with a great selection of furniture for home and outdoor.
Hey, T, we've got to wrap this show up today. Terry,
thank been a
you
good show.
Thank you, folks, for being
thank
a part
you, Ryan.
Of today. Ryan, as always, we thank you. And we'll be back out here tomorrow. Now, it won't be live and in color. It'll be pre-recorded and in color.
That's
in color.
It'll be the next thing to live.
Yeah.
We'll see you tomorrow.